Well, there's plenty going on in the sports world today, but we're going to focus in on a story that has a lot of people's attention. It's a surprising story out of the Atlanta Braves as general manager John Coppolella resigned today as the Braves GM. Now, it might be more of a situation where he was forced to resign. This, according to the team, it all traces back to MLB rules that were broken regarding the international player market. Don't have any more specifics than that at this point. The Braves say the league is investigating the matter and the Braves are cooperating. Coppolella was general manager of the Braves since 2015. He helped turn around Atlanta's minor league system, made some big trades as well, including sending pitcher Alex Wood to the Dodgers and, in a separate deal, acquiring outfielder Matt Kemp. Braves president John Hart will take over GM duties while the team looks for a replacement. Now we bring in Braves insider Kevin McAlpin from our radio partners at 680 The Fan. Kevin, I know you've been in touch with people in the organization all day. What do we know now?
Well, what we know is that MLB has been investigating what the Braves have done on the international market for the last couple of weeks. Really picked up steam here over the last 72 hours or so over the course of this weekend, and that's when things really started getting more serious. So we know that Coppy resigned earlier today, and John Hart will take over as GM in the interim until they find a replacement.
Oh, we're around the team a little bit. You're around the team every day, every game. There's been just talk and rumblings and grumblings all year long, all season long, about maybe some infighting in the front office. Who's in power? Might that have played some role in this?
You know, I think it plays a part. I think it plays a small part, but I really do believe that what the bigger issue here is what's going on the international market. And again, when MLB starts investigating things like this, they take these very seriously. Mm-hmm. So they're going to do their due diligence, and they found enough that obviously that they were questioning what John Coppolella was doing, but also what Gordon Blakely was doing as well.
Well, let's talk about that international player market, and that's what the team says. That's the rules that were broken. That's all we know right now. And under Coppolella, the Braves have brought in some major talent from outside the United States. Here's the former Braves GM talking about Venezuelan infielder, highly regarded prospect Kevin Maton. This is from last July.
From what our scouts say, the best player to come out of Latin America in the last 10 years. And just a chance, it's so hard to find offense in this game, as we've seen here. And he has a chance to be a really special player.
Okay, so we don't know if this situation revolves around Maton or who exactly it is. Taking a look at some video of him here, but so much international talent. Might there be penalties? Might the Braves lose some of these players?
I think more penalties along the lines of maybe monetary or maybe taking away some of the international picks that they can use. I don't know that they're going to lose any players. And I know Ronald Acuna's name is the guy that everyone's wondering, well, what's going to happen with Acuna? Well, he was signed under the previous regime of Frank Wren, so we don't have to even worry about including his name in any of this. Again, I think it'll be more monetary or maybe a reduction of picks internationally than they'll actually physically have players taken away from them.
Last question for you, Kevin. It's going to be a plum job for whatever GM comes in, but the big question we thought we'd be talking about right now is who's going to be the manager of the team next year, Brian Snitker. So what's he thinking right now, and what does this mean for him?
You know, I don't think this changes a lot for Snit, really. I really truly believe that, you know, they were going to have conversations once the season came to an end. I don't think, you know, John Hart taking over on the interim basis as GM changes any of that. I do think they'll have those conversations maybe in the next day or two. And I think that this decision will be made up before they go to Orlando for their organizational meetings, which start next week. So I don't think this changes a whole lot as far as the manager is concerned.
A surprising move in an offseason where we expected maybe some movement in the managerial ranks. Yeah. We get it in the general manager spot. Kevin McAlpin from 680 The Fan, appreciate your time. Of course, we'll keep you posted on this story as it develops here on Fox 5.